A very good evening to one of present here.
Good evening.
So just a few days back, I was going to my project objectives from the current speech of the level 5 of my pathway. And then to speak about my experience. I felt extremely lucky because at one point of time, I had served as an executive committee officer of this club for 3 years in a stretch. So before I start boasting about my experience as a lifetime back, let me make some things very, very clear. Never in my life have I been a leader. Back in my school days, I used to be a middle bencher. I used to sit in between really studious people in the front and really notorious guys in the back. And I was the transition between the two groups. And I never attended college after my first year, even though I was enrolled into one. And neither did anyone from my class. And so, even though I was able to enter into the executive committee in the year 2015, and even though I was able to serve for 3 years, it was all an accident. And sometimes I even wondered how that happened. And in order to tell you guys how that accident happened in the first place, let me take you all back to the month of May 2015. It was a certain Friday evening and I was delivering my fourth speech. I had previously delivered 3 speeches and somehow, someway, for each one of the speeches, I had won the ribbon of the most improved speaker. And I wanted to be the best speaker. It was an obsession. And so, there were 2 speeches that day, including mine. The first speaker, who was delivering his project to, stood silent at one point of time for 20 long seconds. I was already on cloud 9 as I delivered my speech without any kind of hiccups. Time went on, and in the end, I was the most famous speaker for the 4th successive time. What happened was so surprising and so shocking that I readily wanted to become a sergeant arms. None of the club members knew about it, except my mentor and the election officer. So on the election day, 2 people were gunning for the post sergeant arms. And the other candidate who later on go to city of the Toastmasters club and would be the club president there after exactly 1 year. And till date, he has been instrumental in mentoring 2 new clubs to success. While I am still the forgotten immediate past president with no yet leadership in sight. So, trust me when I tell you that my selection that day to the executive committee was purely accidental and I have no clue how that happened. But then, I was there for one selfish intention. I needed to improve. And so, I showed up each and every meeting at 6:30 p.m. and I would speak my heart out. But after 6 months, it felt as if everything was still the same. It felt as if I was still the same Shourya Roy, and I desperately needed something which would make me speak English. But then, this time around, there were more deserving people than me for the post of Sergeant at Arms. And so I decided to go for the next best thing. I took up the post of the secretary. During those days, we did not have the online version of the minutes of the meeting. And my task was to read out the hard copy of the minutes of the meeting very loudly. And I did that with all the gusto which I could master. And when that too did not feel enough, after 6 months, it was time for me to take up another role, which would again return me to speak. But this time, not on the podium, but to different kinds of people. I was the next vice president membership. And time would again pass on like a blur. And this time I was really, really on a tight spot. For 18 months I was used to a role with my selfish intents in the forefront. But now there were no roles left for me to take except the one of the vice president education. And taking up that role would mean effectively putting the interests of others before mine. And I was hopeless and hilariously, I did smile at that. But still, I would take up that post for one particular reason. Deep down, I knew that no matter how abysmal I was, my president was even more abysmal. See, I have walked with that person, same day weeping in the same exhibition comedy. And I knew this person very, very good. Throughout 1 year, me and my president, we complimented each other. I was pathetic at certain things at which he was good at. He was pathetic at certain things at which I was good at. And we understood each other's limitations. And we would remain overly humble for that. And as a result, people would listen to whatever we needed them to do. For example, attending an annual diction contest or participating into what? Sometimes they would listen out of self-pity and sometimes for their own self-development. And in the end, it would all work out really, really well. In Toastmasters, it's a common phenomenon that the results of all the hard work done by a particular executive committee is actually failed by the next term, by the end of the next term. And after everything was done and thus in 2017, our club would go on to win the maximum number of awards in the term of 2017-18. And that number has even increased more in this term. So after serving for 1 year as the Vice President Education, it was actually a matter of honor to be the president starting from January 2018. I felt extremely lucky considering the fact that it all started by an accident. And in the end, it would all end by an accident as well. In the month of May 2018, my grandmother would suffer from her second paralysis stroke in a time span of 10 years. I would rush to the hospital after ending a meeting in this very same spot. And for the rest of the term, neither was I available properly for this club, nor was I available properly for my family. And so, even though I would have loved to continue for 6 more months, I was forced to exit. So, if I was to speak about my experience regarding an executive committee officer, I would say that it has been quite enlightening and full of learnings. Sometimes, no matter how much we plan and perceive, something just does not happen in our lives. And sometimes, the best things in our lives happen just like that, by an accident. My tenure as an executive committee officer of this club represents to me just that. And it's actually a blessing in disguise that I don't get to speak about my learnings here. Because otherwise, I would have never fit all of those into a 10-minute speech. Standing here today, I would like to make one request to each and every one of you. Be an executive committee officer if possible, for 6 months if necessary. It does not matter whether you are comfortable with the job, and it does not matter whether you have the necessary skill sets or not. Just as long as you are passionate with you are involved in, miracles can and will happen. Just as long as you are open-minded enough to learn and grow, wonders can and will happen. Best of luck and thank you.